True, what's good, y'all? Welcome back to another video with your boy KO. I'm out here in LaGrange, Georgia. Show y'all real quick what we picking up. Y'all already know, good old insulation. This will be my second time ever picking this up. So, is it second time? Yeah, I think it's the second time ever picking it up. As y'all know, it gotta be tarp. So this dude is out here strapping his load down. I do have a little ladder thing, but I'm about to ask them to put my tarps on top because I'm not putting tarps up there. But they gotta be strapped down. My manager called me and asked me that I had extra tarps, so they needed a driver needed a tarp. I don't know if this is who she was talking about. This thing say CTI. Maybe that's who she was talking about, because I mean, it's the only truck that's here. It's him, so. Oh no, I say Shelton, okay. Yeah, it is a Shelton driver. All right, so, yeah, that's a Shelton driver. So, that must have been who she was asking me about. So, oh well, I don't have an extra tarp. I used to, but I took them off the truck. I had P&S tarp, so it is what it is. But hopefully they load me up pretty quick. And we'll get this load secured. I'm gonna put my camera on the charger because I didn't know this thing was about to die. So I'll catch up with y'all after I get loaded. All right, y'all. So as y'all see, we are all strapped. Took me like an hour because of how high up this shit is. Y'all know your boy is, I'm a little dude. So, and then putting it up there. So we good now. And they said, you put your tarps out on the ground, like that TMC guy doing. You put it on the ground, and then they come with a pole and they put it across for you. I ain't never seen it, so if I can record it, I'm gonna get that for you. Apparently, that pole that's over there on the ground, they hook it up to it and they drag it over the top for you. So, hey, we gonna see what happens, y'all. I ain't never seen it, but maybe the TMC guy gonna go first, and he got a student, so of course. They moving way faster than me, so. Yeah, he got a student with him, so of course they're gonna do all this shit faster than me, so. I'm just gonna wait, and maybe I can record them getting theirs put on top so y'all can see how it's done. But just wanted to show y'all that real quick. All right, y'all, as y'all see it, we are fully tarped. So I tried to get a video of how he was putting it over. So they hook it up to a bar and he raises it all the way up and he just pulls it over the top. It's pretty cool. They do it with a forklift. I've never seen that done before, so it was cool to see. I tried to record it, but then he needed me to help him. So because you got to hold it on one side so it's evenly. So once he puts it down, they just take a pole and they pull it off, and then as y'all see, I just hook. I'm too short to reach these top ones, so the top part ain't gonna be that good. I ain't gonna lie to you, but it is what it is. It's still there, but I ain't gonna be able to hook that top part like I want to, so I don't really care. It ain't going nowhere. All the other motherfuckers that was here, they left. They ain't tarped this shit, so I'm the only one that tarped this load. But hey, it is what it is. I can't be mad at them. I don't blame them for not parking me. Because, all right, no. Insulation stuff, they can sit it right outside. But on the paperwork, this is what I'm talking about. You can't even sit and be like, you know what? I ain't even know I'm supposed to tarp it. Big as hell. Big as fuck. How you gonna say you ain't know? So, hey, I'm gonna be on the safe side. And mine is tarp, so. Ain't nothing nobody can say to me. But the plus side is, this load is only 6,000 pounds. So I am not mad at it at all. So I need a little bit of fuel. I got 81 miles to get to where I'm parking at. Oh, it's currently day before Thanksgiving. So I probably won't record tomorrow. So I'm saying now, happy Thanksgiving, everybody. Hope y'all have a good Thanksgiving. So I'm gonna see if, yeah, I'm gonna get a little bit of fuel because, hey, I'm probably gonna go take a shower, even though I'm finna go home. We still gonna take a shower anyway, man. I'm dirty. But I'll catch up with y'all when I get to the fuel stop. So we out here, I don't even know the city, but we getting fuel, pump price $3.68. We get it for $2.91. So I'm just gonna put $100. I only need enough fuel just to get to Georgia. Well, not to Georgia, to the other part of Georgia. And then I'm gonna fill up on Sunday when I head out to go back to Florida. So just wanted to show y'all that. I had to fix a couple of the bungees on the back because I didn't hook them right. So that was on my dumb ass. It was blowing in the wind, but once I'm done here, we're gonna go ahead. I think I got like 60 miles to get to where I'm parking at, and I'll catch up with y'all over there. So stay tuned, y'all. You too. What's up, y'all? It is currently Sunday after Thanksgiving, man. Hope y'all had a great Thanksgiving, man. Y'all didn't see it, me and Country was on live last night on Saturday. So if y'all ever had questions, I don't know if we're gonna do it every Saturday, but on Saturday we're probably gonna do a live at 7 o'clock. Like I said, maybe not every Saturday, but you know, y'all ever got any questions that you want answered right away, hop on the live, man. We're streaming from both channels. Power hour, we do it literally for an hour. We hop off, we answer as many questions that we can, and just chop it up, y'all, shoot the shit, and that's it, man. But other than that, man, hope y'all had a great Thanksgiving, man. Mine was good. Got to see my youngest daughter. She gotta get some clothes. It's cold, man. It is right now, it is 29 degrees, and I'm in Macon, Georgia, and it's this cold, so this ain't it, I can tell you that much. So this definitely ain't it. Let me sit y'all down somewhere where y'all can see me. There we go. But yeah, it's cold out here. I ain't used to this. Well, I can't say I ain't used to this, but I ain't too fond of this cold weather, I could, to say the least. But I had a good Thanksgiving other than that, man. This cold weather, that's about it, man. So we got about 300 and something miles to go to get over to, where are we going? Sarasota. Going to Sarasota, Florida. Might stop in Tampa first and then go to Sarasota, but we gonna see. So I don't know if I'm gonna do that yet, or I might just go straight through, because as I told y'all, I'm not working tomorrow. I'm gonna take tomorrow off. I got a couple things I need to handle tomorrow after I make this delivery. So I'm not really in a rush to make this delivery, but at the same time, I wanna get it out of the way. So I did look up the place that I'm delivering to, and from the looks of it, that place is super small. It's right on the beach, man. So it's right on the beach, so that should be interesting for sure. So I might have to take this tarp off before I get over there, because I was looking at it this morning and I remember the dude told me it's some condominiums that they building over there, and it ain't a lot of room over there, to be honest. Oh, that's still there. Oh, I need to put that back on. Yeah, this thing been, this load, this tarp has been a absolute nightmare, to say the least, man. I didn't damn near use all my bungees on this thing. It's really just the back flap. This shit keep coming loose because these freaking tarp got holes in them. But I might have to end up taking these tarps off anyway, because from the looks of it, like I said, that street is really, really small, and I know I'm not gonna have space. Like, it's like a literally like a two-lane street on the beach. So I know I'm not gonna have a lot of room. So I'm probably gonna take these tarps off today and just go ahead and fold them, because I know I'm not gonna be able to do it there. Shit, I probably won't have room to pull it off, because if I pull it off to the side, I'm gonna be in that street. So it ain't even worth trying to deal with the hassle of that. So we're gonna probably pull these off today, get it out of the way, go ahead and get it rolled up. That way tomorrow when I get there, it's a lot easier. I should have just pulled it off before I started driving, but it is what it is, man. But pump price here, I didn't tell y'all. Pump price, $363, and we get it for $289, I believe. Is it $289? Yeah, $289. So I'm gonna finish topping this off. Oh, actually, oh no, that's the dude next to me. Yeah, I'm gonna finish topping this off and then get on down the road. It's cold as all get out, man. Hope y'all have a great morning. Hope y'all have a great weekend. Whatever time you're seeing this, it's probably gonna be a weekday when you see it. Probably gonna be Friday when you see this. So I hope y'all have a great weekend, because by the time you see it, it is gonna be the weekend. Anyway, y'all catch up with y'all later. Man, I was getting ready to pull off, but man, look at that. Woo, that bad boy is pretty. I think that's a pure built 386, I believe. Don't quote me on that. But if I'm not mistaken, that's a 386. I'm learning my Peterbilt, you know, day by day. If I'm gonna get one, I'm gonna learn them. But yeah, I believe that's what they call that. That's a 386, man. That thing is gorgeous. Got another Pete right there. That's a 579 right there. I know that for sure. But I believe, if I'm not mistaken, that's what they consider a 386. Which I wouldn't mind getting one of them either. Those things are beautiful. I didn't even know there was a 386 until I started doing my research on these 579s, and that's how I found out about the 386. I would take a 386, man. If I got my hands on one, I would take one. The only thing is, I know with most companies, I think they stopped making those 386. I think they stopped at like 14 or something like that. I could be wrong, but I think they stopped at like 14 or maybe before that. So I can't get a newer one. You know how these companies, they gotta be 10 years, blah, blah, blah. So I think that's why I never really looked at the 386s, because they're older. I don't think you can get newer ones, but if you can, hey, let me know. Y'all know I don't know anything about these Peets. I'm learning. I know Freightliner, but I don't know Peets, but we learning though. Y'all, top of the morning, man. I'm out here. I'm in Bradenton. I actually made it here yesterday, probably around about 5 o'clock. As y'all see, I did take the back tarp off already. I just unbungeed the front tarp. I'm about to take it off because, like I said, I looked up the place and it's probably like a two-lane road with a job site, so it's not a lot of room. So put y'all, sit y'all down. Turn y'all back around. There you go. It's like a job site, so it ain't a lot of room, so I don't even feel like I'll be able to take that tarp off. As y'all see, it's blue skies and all that, so it ain't about to rain or anything, so I'ma just rock out like that, to be honest. Just take the tarp off if they want. I got videos of this shit tarped, so it's not like I'm trying to finesse y'all. I took a picture of it tarped, everything, so they can see, like, you know what I'm saying, it's not damaged or anything from rain. I'm 13 miles away from the freaking delivery, so, and I'm about to head over there now. So I'm just pulling this tarp off because that road, like I said, it's literally super small. They may have a pull-off area, but y'all seen how wide these tarps are when you gotta fold it on the ground. That's a pain. I ain't mastered the trick of how they fold that shit on the side of the trailer. We gonna learn that one though. I done seen some girls do it and everything. I'm like, we gonna learn it. I just never been showed that way, so because if I knew how to do that, then I wouldn't even care. I'd just go hook this thing up to the trailer, swoop, 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 and be gone. You know what I'm saying? But, hey, it is what it is. I park. This right here is behind me. It's a gym. It's the gym out here. It's the LA Fitness out here in Bradenton. I park back here all the time when I'm in this. If I have a delivery nearby, I just park here. I just went to the gym this morning. That's why I got my headphones on and stuff. But I worked out this morning. We're going to grab this tarp off, and then we're going to go ahead and knock this out. After this, like I told you, I'm taking the rest of the day off. I might work tomorrow. I'm still debating. We're going to see, because I'm supposed to be bringing y'all some content for this Vlogmas, but we're going to see what happens, y'all. So let me go ahead and get this tarp pulled off, and I'm going to catch back up with y'all. right, y'all. So we out here. We made it to the job site, as y'all see. It's right off the lake, man. Beautiful, beautiful views. These are the condominiums that they're building right here. Well, they already built. It looked like they been built. No. They haven't been built. Well, maybe they have. They might be remodeling them. I'm not really sure, but this is where I'm delivering to. So pretty nice, dope spot. It's literally right off this lake. Let me show y'all this lake real quick. Over here, that's the guy. He's gonna load me. He's gonna load me with a Moffitt. So that shit gonna take a while. But this is the lake. This is the view, man. Man, whoever moving to these condominiums, man, they gonna have a nice view, man. That's the lake. And then if you come out this exit right here, if you come out right there, the beach is right there. Which that's where I'm gonna go end the video at. So I'm gonna show y'all the beach view too. But yeah, they definitely remodeling these. Yeah, see the people down there, all that junk down there on the side, they're taking stuff out. So they remodel them. Hey, y'all see, I had this thing tarped, right? And I took the tarp off before I got here. Y'all see where they're putting it at? Right there. They sitting all this shit right outside. This is exactly why your boy don't be wanting to tarp these lows, man. For what? For y'all to do that? But I did tarp it. I took it off before I got here. So, hey, can't nobody say nothing to me. But I did have to. I came in. I just parked on the side. I'll show y'all where I parked at. I walked over and the dude said, it's probably easy for you to turn around and back in. Which I did get some dope. I did get some dope footage for y'all of me backing up. I actually, since my camera has a magnet on it, so I hooked the magnet up to the back of the trailer and showed me backing in, so y'all can see how far. Well, it wasn't a complete distance, but y'all see where I backed in from. So hopefully it came out pretty dope. I think it did. I think it will if it caught the angle right. But we gonna see, y'all. But I just wanted to show y'all that real quick. Here go the installation. You can see it better. It's right there. They stacking it all up right outside. So, hey, it is what it is, man. I'm gonna end the video out on the beach. All right, y'all. So we out here at the beach, man. This is the condominiums right here that they rebuilding. I think they got affected by the hurricane. So, cause they're only doing the first two levels. So I feel like that's what happened. They got affected. They might be doing all levels, but right now they start at the bottom. So that's probably what happened. They probably got affected by that storm and now they remodeling the whole thing. But this is the part of the job that makes it worth it, man. The beach view, man. I knew it was gonna be a nice scenery. This is a Siesta Key Beach. I've been here before, outside of work. Super nice, man. Sometimes you gotta sit back and embrace it, man. The plus side of being a truck driver. We get to see a lot of stuff that a lot of people don't get to see. Beach is something a lot of people can see, but then again, there's a lot of people that ain't never been to Florida at the same time, so. But yeah, man, beach, Big Red, we done, man. So now, it took them about an hour to take it off because like I said, they've taken off stack by stack and I think I had like 24 stacks on there. So that took a whole hour, but we done now. I did let my manager know that I have to go pick up my mom's ashes today. So I'm not working the rest of today. I gotta go do that. I gotta handle some other stuff. So, and then Thursday and Friday, I'm taking off as well because my oldest daughter is got accepted to Florida State. So, she has orientation Friday. So, I gotta go to Tallahassee. So, we ain't working much this week. So, unfortunately, I won't be having a lot of videos. The boy won't be working. So, and, other than that, y'all, I appreciate y'all for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, turn on my post notification. Oh yeah, as far as the December giveaway, me and Country did come up with an idea for it, and I'll let y'all know in the next video. Payroll, I forgot to tell y'all payroll Friday, that week prior. My gross was 71, and my take home was 41 and some change, almost 4,200. So super good week. I can't be mad at it, man. I ain't had a good week like that in a while. But anyway, y'all, appreciate y'all for watching. Skateboard K, another loan in the books. Catch y'all on the next one. Peace.